Welcome to my channel, or welcome back. I'm Monica Hill, and on my channel I talk about living. On Saturdays I try to talk about spiritual food or fuel. On Sundays, my vegan journey. I'm way off track and need to really get back on track. On Monday, books and business. On Tuesdays, do-it-yourself projects. On Wednesday, my hair journey to grow my hair all the way to waistline. On Thursdays, music and poetry. And on Fridays, fun fitness challenges. In my background, you see a big red rose. And this video, some may not consider it a spiritual fuel video, but it is to me. This poem represents love. And this video is really going out to all the women. It goes out to my daughters, but especially women of domestic violence. Roses are reds, violets are blue, not your eyes. Love yourself, respect yourself, and defend yourself too. That was my Thursday poetry wrapped up in this video. Now, this topic is very serious. I am not an authority, a professional counselor, psychiatrist, or anything like that. And I'm just going to tell you straight from my heart and from my experiences. Growing up in my life, young men that I grew up around, young black men, always seemed to find it an honor to have many women. That was just the way it is that I have observed. And usually, I have come to my own conclusion that when a man is cheating, he feels like his woman is cheating, okay? And he turns it around and makes her feel like she's doing something wrong. To all the women out there who may be in physical relationships, my marriage, my second marriage, almost got physical. My husband and I do not fight. I repeat, my husband and I do not fight. I choose not to even use cuss words, but I will if I feel like I need to. And I have in the past. When someone has cussed me, I can let them know, honey, you, that's a word, I can say it too. But I choose not to use that type of language. Growing up, I watched my mom, and I hope my mom doesn't mind, in the name of women and taking up for yourself. I watched my mom during her second marriage to my stepdad fight sometimes. My mom was a fighter. She did not take a lick and keep on ticking. My mama took them and she gave them back, and then she kept on ticking. And she was married to a strong man. I'm married to a very strong man. My body is not made like his. His body is very strong. He can overpower me. And my mom would sometimes get into fights after a party. They would have car parties, be having a good time, company go home some kind of way. My mom and her husband get into an argument. Next thing you know, boom, 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 it turned to a fight. And as a little girl, it scared me. And I used to cry. And I remember one particular time, excuse me, I went to my mom's room to help her. And she had a water bed, and they were on the bed. My mom was on the bottom, her husband was on the top, and I jumped on them and I tried to bite them as hard as I could. And probably the harder that I bit, the harder he was on her. And she told me, get up, get up, get off, get off. She told me, go back to my room. So I went back to my room and I cried. And from there on out, I never tried to help my mom again. And all I would do when my mom would get into these fights, because I couldn't see what was going on. But honey, one time I heard my mama say, do it, MF, do it. And she didn't say MF, she said the word. I dare you, MF, do it. Honey, I don't know what was going on and what was going to be done, honey. I just know that it was not a pleasant thing to go through as a child. I have never been involved in domestic abuse with a husband or a boyfriend. I have seen women, I have seen men that I have been involved with. I haven't I have seen men and women fight. Even a man that I was involved with give a woman black eyes. Not me, but I didn't understand some things that I understand now. So I'm making this video, hope it's not gonna be too long, excuse me, not to make anyone look bad, not to shame myself, but to tell you the truth, my testimony, and a very important story to help free you, to free your mind, to let you know it is not okay. It is not okay to stay in a relationship that you know will turn volatile, will turn into violence. There is no purse, honey, no shoes, no house, no neighborhood that is worth your freedom, your appearance for the sake of keeping up appearances. I'm wearing no makeup on purpose. So this is my part right here. Just tuck my hair back there. But I'm wearing no makeup so you can see my face. As I said, we did not get into a fight, but it was going that route. Had I smiled, had I gotten smart, I was one slap away. I was one punch away from that situation from happening. So I know it's time for me to go. And in the middle of the night, I told my husband, that's not the first time. That's the third time it got to this point. I said, during the time that it was going on, we had an exchange of words or I was being questioned. I said, you're gonna do this again? Oh, this is the last time. This is the last time. And after I had a chance, I stayed calm. I wasn't shocked this time. I was calm and cool and collected as a cucumber, nothing but the Lord. I told my husband not to make my husband look bad. In the middle of the night, husband, I don't want those type of memories with you. I love you. We just have differences of meanings of what marriage is supposed to be. And so to anyone out there, my husband and I, we celebrated our 10th wedding anniversary. And you know, you have intuition as a woman. You know when things are not right. Deep down inside, God will reveal things to you. And I knew that we were coming to an end. It did not have to be that way, but people choose how they want to live. They choose to not make certain choices and decisions, and it's okay for things to end. When something ends, it means it's the beginning of something new, something beautiful, a new beginning. There's nothing wrong with new beginnings. So I encourage you women, to if you have a loving relationship, let it end in love. It doesn't have to end in violence. Roses are red, violets are blue, not your eyes, not your body parts. Love yourself, respect yourself, and defend yourself too.